way to have an impact individually or corporately with people is to overflow in the Spirit. And we agree on that. To overflow in the Spirit. Because the moment that we settle for the mediocre, that's religion.
Uh-huh.
That's just staying put with A plus B equals C and that's it. We need to overflow that we may reach our loved ones and many that are hurting out there right now. And boy, there's so much going on right now. First of all, thank you, Pastor Jose, the church, and Hermana Patricia for the invitation. After being running here and there all over the place, I got in Saturday night and I was like feeling kind of drained and started dealing with a cold. And I get a message from Pastor Jose, we'd like for you to minister here. And I was like, oh God, give me the message. Give me the message, because I don't want to just stand here and go blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. Said, Lord, remove me if I just go blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. Pull me by the ears and get me away if I just start to go blah, blah, blah. Because there's plenty of confusion out there already.
Yeah.
We don't need any more confusion.
That's right.
So to every man and every woman, we should be praying, Lord, teach me.
Yeah.
Anoint me for such a time as this.
Thank you, Lord.
That's right.
And it's very important. Just like the chef, when he's putting everything together, his recipes and everything else, you know, says, boy, I would not want to just throw this out, and the people at the restaurant are like, oh my God, it's pretty bland.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So for such a time as this,
amen.
The devastation, it is horrible. For many that refuse to see what is going on from California through all the fires, all the way to Houston, in every state and nations and all nations, even what we see at times when we see wickedness in high places, we should be in prayer. Debemos estar en oración y en ayuno. Because when we make it a Sunday thing, it'll always be a Sunday thing. When we make it a godly thing, when we allow the Spirit of God to move in such a way as the Lord, have your way.
Yes.
People are hurting. Not just in the county jails, in the prisons, but look at the homelessness that we're facing. Mira nomás la gente que está sin hogar, que han batallado tanto después de las lumbres en California, y las batallas tremendas que han enfrentado en sus hogares, que han perdido todo. Pero gloria a Dios que aparte de todos estos problemas, hay un Dios vivo que podemos aclamar. Praise be to God that aside from everything that is going on, there is that living God that we can call upon.
Yes, amen.
To restore. You know, as this week was going through, I had a message that I said, Lord, give me the message. And I just, you know, wrote the title. And I just kind of kept, as they say, you start to get ants in your pants. Like, well, Lord, I'm giving this call. And why do I deal with this? How do I? And it seemed like God was saying, just chill out. You know, this is, calm down. You know, it's just, I'm going to give you the message. It's going to be all right, just, you know, because we, you know, we get excited as well. We get super excited because we want to be blessed. And, you know, I just wouldn't want to come here and just throw some crumbs. Say, here you go, because
thank you.
No way.
Oh, thank you.
To God be the glory in every way, in everything going on this day and the days ahead. You know, there is devastation. Yes, there are situations individually and corporately going on right now. It's like, oh my God, you know, even within our governments, even within families and all over. But praise be to God that He is doing a mighty work. Because the enemy would want to clog up our ears with opinion.
Oh yeah.
El enemigo quisiera empaparnos con opinión, nuestros oídos. Con opinión del mundo. Para que no escuchemos el poder de Dios y la palabra de Dios. That we don't hear the word of God and the Spirit of God ministering to us for such a time as this. And I'll tell you, it gets pretty wild, but praise be to God. The Hebrew word says Jehovah Shammah.
Yes.
God is there in every way. He is our Jehovah Rapha, our healer. And our Jehovah Jireh, our provider.
Yes.
And I say this day, as the word says, to the city, to the nation, to Alpine and Mark and all the surrounding communities, that these are the rules of engagement
yes.
for such a time as this. Either we're engaged with the power of the living God, or we're not. Mm-hmm. And that's what the enemy would want to do. To keep a church in the area of complacency.
Yeah.
To keep people that's a conformist with these opinions that are out there, mm-hmm. but not the power of God.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
I'm believing. Praise be to God. As this year, as we come into this new year, we're going to need more.
Yes.
That overflow of the Spirit, that overflow of the Word, that we can reach out to those that are hurting, and that will keep us going and going and going for such a time as this. And the message for today and for the area, and I'm munching myself too. I'm knitted too. I don't want to ever say up here, well, y'all are down there. No, we're all down here.
Yeah.
I'm not sitting on top of a cloud. Yo no estoy arriba una nube. No estoy arriba una nube que digan aquí estoy y ustedes aquí. No. Dios, enséñame. Enséñame cosas grandes y milagrosas para el tiempo como hoy. Hallelujah. And the message today is titled Beauty for Ashes. The oil of joy for mourning, and the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness.
Yes.
Restoration power for the new year. Because perhaps there's some of us personally that need to be restored.
Amen.
Well, we have a family member that needs to be restored. Well, there's certain people in leadership that need to be restored.
Yes.
That means there's certain people in leadership in churches.
Yes.
And even leadership in governments.
Yes.
Because if we focus that everything is la-di-da, everything's so great, yet we're going to throw our trust completely in the leadership of the country, that's not the case. That is not the case. Praise be to God that He's showing us great and mighty things. That everything that people are facing, that there is a God.
Amen.
That's going to deliver us.
Yes.
He said, do not fear, for I'm with you.
Amen.
Do not be dismayed, for I'm thy God. I will strengthen you. I will uphold you with the right hand of my righteousness. You know, as I cried and cried and cried this past week at Lackland Air Force Base at my daughter's graduation, I would talk to her and I cried and talked to her and I cried and whatever. I said, but when is he going to stop crying? I said, what's the deal with him? But you know, I just praise be to God and showed me to move from fear to faith.
Amen.
From fear to faith. Every morning that they're more a faith. De temor a fe, diariamente, porque hay mucho ahorita en estos momentos que está ocurriendo de una parte, de una orilla de la nación al otro día, from one end of the nation to the other end, so much that we refuse to be distracted because we know whom we serve. Sabemos a quién servimos, en quién hemos creído, gloria a Dios. El mensaje se titula Aceite de gozo en lugar de luto, manto de alegría en lugar del espíritu angustiado, restauración de poder para el año nuevo. Beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, and the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness.
Yeah.
We're going to just take that on today and tomorrow and all week long and all year long. You know, and just continue to just overflow with the word and the spirit.
Yeah.
And just continue to move on in such a way that we can have that impact. Because, you know, people are hurting. I'm on the phone with people sometimes in the middle of the night, and I'm dealing with sometimes with family, and I'll tell you, you know, I say, well, you know, here's God. Mm-hmm. If you want Him, submit to Him.
Yes.
Don't just believe in Him, but live for Him.
Yes.
No solo creas en Dios, pero vive por Él. Porque el mundo no es. También el enemigo cree en Dios. Él sabe que hay un Dios, pero no le sirve. See, there's an enemy out there that believes there's a God. But he doesn't live for Him. So it is important that we get away from the thinking and say, you know, this is time. This year is going to be a year of mighty blessings. And I like, I always call my mother up and in the morning I say, repeat after me. And I'm going to ask you that you repeat also. If you feel free, if you don't, it's up to you. If those that want to wish to repeat this morning, for today, for the year, for your lives and the years ahead, I receive the blessings
of God.
In the abundance,
of health.
Of love,
and of prosperity.
Answer prayers. miracles
this day
and the days ahead,
this year
and the years ahead, in the name of Jesus. Yo recibo bendiciones en abundancia de salud, de amor y prosperidad. Grandes milagros, grandes bendiciones en este día y los días venideros, en este año y los años venideros, en el nombre de Jesús. See, that's a beautiful thing about it, that if we don't declare anything, guess who else is going to declare something? So if we declare, if we allow, we start speaking to our spirit, to our mind, to our soul, beautiful things are going to start happening. Because right now I'm dealing with a ministry at the county jail for years at different locations and very, you know, hardcore situations. And many are trapped into this defeat. That's the work of the enemy, to keep people in that snare. A tener el enemigo quiere tenernos a muchos en esa trampa. Pero gloria a Dios, que Dios está obrando poderosamente. That God is moving in such a way. Remember that He says He's bringing the beautiful ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, and that garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Because there's been heaviness, there's been situations personally in our lives, in our families, situations all over the place. But praise be to God that He's there, He's coming to me. It says, and I will give you rest. And how powerful it is. I wanted to concentrate this morning, focus on the area, on those areas of the beauty. Psalms 27, verse 1. Quisiera concentrar en hermosura. Salmo 27, capítulo 27, versículo 1. The book of Psalms, chapter 27, and verse 1. Oh, praise be to God. Hallelujah. That He is the living God.
Yes,
hallelujah. Psalms 27, and verse 1. We thank God for everything. Hallelujah. It's so right to say hallelujah. I bet there's no laws out there within Casino County. Casino County of the state is going to say, oh, whoa, wait a minute. You cannot have him. It's so right to praise Him. It's so right to say hallelujah. No hay leyes, no hay reglas que te estén quitando el permiso de elegir. Hallelujah. De alabarle. Alabale, porque es el Dios vivo. Praise Him, because He is a living God.
Yes, He is.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Gloria a Dios, capítulo 27, versículo 1. Dios se está manifestando poderosamente. Hallelujah. Verse 1. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Speaking about beauty. He says, the Lord is my light and my salvation.
Yes.
Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing I have desired of the Lord, that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
Yes.
To behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in His temple.
Amen.
For in the time of trouble He shall hide me in His pavilion. In the secret place, in the secret of His tabernacle, shall He hide me. He shall set me upon a rock.
Yes.
Woo, hallelujah. See, there it is. See that beauty. And it's so powerful. He said, to behold the beauty of the Lord.
Amen.
When we're talking that beauty, we're talking that presence of the Holy Spirit, that sweet perfume, to really be in there. Remember that the Word says that He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High
shall
abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Praise God. Praise God.
To be in that presence, in that prayer, or the fasting, or the word, yes, in submission to the living God.
Yes.
There's that beauty right there. Remember he said, if you want to go with beauty for ashes, that's the beauty to rise above the ashes of situations that are going on all over.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And this is really, really beautiful, and it just really... He says, one thing I shall seek after that I may dwell in the house of the day. Mm-hmm. Just think about this. All the days of my life.
Yes.
See, that's submission to God. This is a traditional thing that, well, we made it to church Sunday morning and it takes care of that. Now I can jump on the old camel and head back to Egypt. The world is mine. Oh, yeah, sure. In a lot of cases, the camel didn't make it back and it fell in the middle of the desert. So, oh, what happened to Job? Well, then it's out there somewhere in the middle of the desert, you know, with that situation that just wasn't good at all, you know.
Yeah.
¿Qué pasó con José? ¿Qué pasó con aquel hombre que entró ese día, la iglesia ese domingo, y dijo que todo el mundo era de él? Solo creyendo en Dios y se fue a sus ideas, a su modo de vivir. Regresó a Egipto durante la semana, dijo, acá el domingo de la semana que entra regreso. Eso es religión. Y no regresó. Porque esa situación lo dejó trampado y ese camello se derrotó, cayó de pura trompa en el desierto y además está ahí. He gets wow. You know, but praise be to God that in everything there is that solution, that answered prayer, that word, and we continue to stay in there no matter what they continue to tell us. It's like, oh my God, there they go yelling and singing and making all that noise.
Yeah.
That place in the corner.
Hallelujah.
That's all right. We're going to make that noise.
Yeah.
Yes. We're going to continue to stay engaged,
Lord,
because warfare, worship is warfare.
Yes, it is.
And because we just decided to turn everything off and said, oh, you know what's, oh, the end is, oh, I got him in that corner of depression, I got him, I'm going to play the music, you know. But that way, he doesn't want to get fired up in the worship music. He's afraid what the family might say, the neighbors might say. No, that's all right. Fire up for such a time as this. And this is really, really beautiful. And I was thinking about this beauty. Estaba concentrado en esta hermosura. Porque increíble, como les ha dicho, like I told you, it wasn't easy going through this areas of depression, going through this areas of divorce, going and raising two girls as a single parent, but the beauty about it is serving him.
Yeah.
That he carried me through.
Yeah.
And I told someone this morning, I'd do it again. Mm-hmm. I just said, Lord, I would just jump in there again and just do that again. I said, because he is there for me.
Yeah.
The presence and the beauty of the Spirit, bringing forth beauty, even in your thinking, bringing forth areas of victory, not defeat.
Yes.
Faith and not fear.
Yes.
Fe y no temor en cada situación, porque el mundo se ha trampado ahorita en varias situaciones tremendas. And so we just praise God for this, you know, that he's given us and continues to give us, because he loves us.
Yes, he does.
So, you know, from all these situations that has happened in California and happened all over the nation and all nations right now, we turn on the news, it's like, oh my God, it hurts. But you know what? We lift up our hands and we intercede for the people in California, the people in Syria, the people in all nations, even the the leadership in governments.
Yeah.
When we go like, oh my God, what is he doing? I can't believe he's doing this. So, Lord, we pray for direction.
That's it.
The one thing that the Word says is that he would remove the stumbling blocks as well. Even within churches, he's removing the stumbling blocks.
Yes.
Because if I decide to say this and say that and all this mumbo jumbo doesn't end up with the Word, he says, Lord, let's go. Mm-hmm. Just pull me away and say, get out of here, go home. And you know, so I want to bring honor and glory to him.
Yes, amen.
Oh, honra y gloria a él.
Yes.
Es pura chuliada, es pura bendición en la presencia de Dios. Una hermosura. That's the beauty we should be calling for, that we can share the testimony.
Amen.
The other area of concentration is that oil of joy.
Yeah.
Es aceite de gozo. Out of Matthew 25 and verse 1. El libro de San Mateo, capítulo 25 y versículo 1. A Dios sea la gloria y sea la honra por todo lo que está haciendo. He's moving in such a way, even in my life, and You know, I just give him the glory and honor.
Yeah.
Matthew 25 and verse 1.
Yeah.
Oil of joy. The oil of joy. What, you know, it's some another. I just like to touch on certain areas and the beauty and the oil of joy and the garment of praise and see what God has just ministered to our spirit this morning. And it says, the oil of joy, aceite de gozo. Aquí estamos en este mensaje, dice, then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins which took their lamps, excuse me, and went forth to meet the bridegroom.
Yes.
And 5 of them were wise and 5 were foolish. Mm-hmm. They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. Mm-hmm. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept.
Oh.
And at midnight there was a cry made, mm-hmm. Behold, the bridegroom cometh, go ye out to meet him. Mm-hmm. And all those virgins who rose and trimmed their lamps. Mm-hmm. And the foolish said unto the wise, give us your oil, for our lamps are gone out. But the wise answered, saying, no, not so, lest there be not enough for us and you. But you go rather to them and sell and buy for yourselves. Mm-hmm. And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in with him to the marriage, and the door was shut.
Uh-huh.
Oh my God, it's getting serious now. Mm-hmm. Afterward came also the other virgins, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. Mm-hmm. But he answered and said, verily I say unto you, I know you not.
Oh,
God. Ooh. Mm-hmm. It says, watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh.
That's right.
See, we either operating under the oil of a joy, the oil of joy of the Holy Spirit. We either operating under God or we're not. All symbolic to the Holy Spirit in every part of the Bible.
Yes.
And we see the seriousness here. And said, well, they went to buy. This is after they came out. This is right here. I say unto you, verse 12, but he answered and said unto you, verily I say unto you, I know you not. Mm-hmm. You know, it's so we see the importance of the Holy Spirit. We see the importance of the Word. See, the Word is not going to flow without the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
It's just going to be cut and dry. It's just going to be, I can draw so much theology here. Puedo meter mucha teología aquí, pero si el Espíritu Santo no se está manifestando, es pura teología. Mm. El Espíritu tiene que estar alineado. I have to be aligned with the Spirit of God. If not, it's just all this theology, cut and dry.
Mm-hmm.
And it's right here the importance. Dice aquí, después vinieron también las otras vírgenes diciendo, Señor, Señor, ábrenos. Mas él respondiendo dijo, de cierto os digo que no os conozco.
Mm.
See, that all of the of joy, we, it's for us. It's our blessing. It's our, you know, we're entitled to that. Función para el tiempo como hoy, para que la palabra se comience a revelar tremendamente. That the word would start to reveal itself. See, even the oil of joy, you know, it's just, for such a time as this,
is
very powerful.
Yes, it is.
See, but the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps.
Mm-hmm.
See, in order to reach out in a world of darkness, you know, we can take this little, nice little mini message and say, well, you know, this and that, and they'll look at you like, yeah, sure. Lord, lead us with your spirit. Mm-hmm. Lead us, Lord, help us to go forth like fresh fire
mm-hmm.
for such a time as this.
Amen.
You know, there's said to say certain beliefs and certain denominations that don't have no emphasis on the Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
No hay creencias tremendas hoy en día que no le dan emphasis, no le dan focus al Espíritu Santo. They look at it like, oh yeah, yeah, don't get too excited now. Don't start jumping up and down. Don't start praying in tongues. You know, why not?
Oh,
why not go into those areas? Why not think outside the box and speak outside the box and live outside the box where the Spirit of God is?
Yes, thank you, Lord.
There's liberty.
Yeah.
Donde el Espíritu de Dios está, ahí hay libertad. Remember that he is doing something here individually and corporately.
Yes.
He's bringing forth the oil of joy for mourning.
Yeah.
There's times that we cry with situations. There's times that things are happening in our families. That things are happening all over the nation.
Yes.
But see, if we want to, you know, excuse me, trade that oil, that mourning for the oil of joy, he's saying, yes. Here I am.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yes.
Yes. You know, it's really awesome because he wants to bless us.
Yes, he does.
And beyond all this opinion that's out there, it's power.
Mm-hmm.
The power of the living God. Más que la opinión, hay el poder de Dios. Y más que religión, hay el Espíritu de Dios. More than religion is the Spirit of the living God.
Mm-hmm.
Remember that he's just given us an oil of joy for mourning, you know, and everything that, you know, a lot of times people are just so devastated with a situation and they stay locked into that situation.
Yeah.
In defeat. And the enemy, and he just comes in and says, I got him. I got him right there. He's just totally paralyzed in fear or in depression or this or that and blah, blah, blah. But God is saying, wow. Overflow in that joy,
yes.
And that oil, that of the Holy Spirit, the beauty and the presence of the Spirit. And as a shared testimony, I grew up in an area of thinking, an area of religion that, you know, we're listening to the Word, and it was great, and I was listening, and I said, wait a minute, whoa. I said, something's missing here. Something's missing here. Until I came into the presence of the Spirit of the living God, said, Lord, baptize me with the Holy Spirit. Let your word come alive in my life. And I don't care if I'm praying in tongues in the shower, praying in tongues at the wrong time or this and that. And I'll tell you, there's so much beauty and so much power within that that brings all the glory and honor to God.
Yes, it does.
Para que Dios reciba la gloria y reciba la honra, especialmente para el tiempo como hoy, necesitamos un énfasis fuerte en el Espíritu de Dios, en el Espíritu Santo. Aceite de gozo para el tiempo como hoy. En el libro de Mateo, capítulo 9, from the book of Matthew, chapter 9, and verse 20. Gloria a Dios, capítulo 9, San Mateo, versículo 20. Dios se está manifestando poderosamente en todo. Gloria a su nombre, capítulo 20. Talk about the garment now. The garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. The garment. And there are certain areas that say, Lord, which one do you want me to go in this message? And so it's opening up the translations, the concordance. I said, well, I'll just go this way. And go up. I said, Lord, teach me.
Amen.
You show me, dear God.
Yeah.
Matthew chapter 9, verse 20, versículo 20. Hablando del manto, dice: he aquí una mujer enferma de flujo de sangre desde hacía 12 años se le acercó por detrás y tocó el borde de su manto, porque decía dentro de sí: si tocare solamente su manto, será salva. Pero Jesús, volviéndose y mirándola, dijo: ten ánimo, hija, tu fe te ha salvado. Y la mujer fue salva desde aquella hora. And behold, a woman which was diseased with an issue of blood 12 years came behind him and touched the hem of his garment. For she said within herself, if I may but touch his garment, I shall be whole. But Jesus turned him about, and when he saw her, said, daughter, be of good comfort. Thy faith had made thee whole. And the woman was made whole from that hour.
Mm-hmm.
See, that garment of praise,
yes,
for the spirit of heaviness,
yeah,
we need it. We need it so much to stay in praise, to stay in worship.
Mm-hmm.
And those areas of, you know, just stepping out in faith that you touch the hem of his garment to be healed. Because there's those areas that go like, oh my God, what is going on here? It's getting pretty serious.
Yeah.
You know, you think somebody comes around, like I shared with you last message, that, you know, you sit with a group of people that are not aligned with the, you know, the Spirit of God, and they've got all this opinion, and you, we respect them, but they're like, you know, they got a lot of intellect, and all of a sudden they're all wearing white coats.
Yeah.
They're all, all of a sudden they're all doctors,
all
and
right.
giving all sorts of opinion. That's like, oh, God. And all of a sudden it seems like they almost want to operate you. Operate in your living room.
Uh-huh.
Y si le damos esa oportunidad a las opiniones, parece ser que ya todos son doctores y todos están ahí sentados y ya te quieren operar ahí en tu misma casa. Pero Dios no lo va a permitir. See, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. And I remember struggling with depression back in 1990 and said, oh my God, what am I going through? Then God said, do not fear, for I'm with you. Do not be dismayed, for I'm like God, I will strengthen you. Me acuerdo ese tiempo de depresión. Dije, Señor mi Dios, ¿qué está pasando? 4 meses y medio. 4 months and a half. I was like, oh my God. But just God helped me to rise above that, to take authority, to get in prayer, to get in fasting, to put on that garment of praise.
Yes.
To fire up the worship music and say, God, I need more.
Yeah, yeah.
I need to overflow in your spirit.
Yeah.
I need that beauty. Necesito la hermosura. I need that oil of joy. And I need that garment of praise for that spirit of heaviness.
Yes, yes.
The world needs it right now.
Yes.
They're so devastated by so many political situations and situations that are going on around us in so many situations. And even within churches and everywhere, it's like, God, we need you.
Yes.
We need you for such a time as this.
Hallelujah.
We need that garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness.
Yes.
Because all of a sudden we're just going like, oh my God, what is going on here? And then it's like, oh, he's wobbling around. He's got to fall on his face. I hope he does. And, you know, but it's not the case.
Yeah, that's right.
We put on that full armor, we put on that garment of praise, and stay in the word, and whatever the people are saying, it's like, oh my God, here they go. It's what I tell them in jail. Digo los que están en la cárcel. Digan lo que digan tus primos, porque parece ser que sobran primos cuando quieres cambiar. See that? The moment you want to change, there's always plenty of relatives that say, what got into you? We thought we were going to go out there Saturday night, and you know, what's going on with you right now? Immediately they want to pull you by the ears and say, but we got to go that way, and we got to go do this, and got to do that. See, we got to be determined.
Mm-hmm.
See, I want that beauty, and I want that oil of joy, and I want that garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness that I've been struggling with when I was a little kid, or when I was, or this past week, or whatever is going on in my life. I need that garment of praise. I need the presence and the beauty of the Spirit for such a time as this, in order to be restored for the new year. See, I need areas of restoration too. I'm not standing here, oh, everything's going so great, la di da, you know, blah, blah, blah. No, I need restoration power for this year.
Praise God.
Because I love the ministry. I've got family. God knows every need, even the desires of my heart. So I want that beauty. Quiero la deseo la hermosura de la presencia de Dios. I want that oil of joy. And I want to put on the garment of praise for any spirit of heaviness and everything that comes around. So I may be able to reach out to the men at the jail, or my daughters, or my son-in-law, or my family, to be engaged in the Word and the Spirit of God.
Amen. Yes.
And I've got to stay engaged for such a time as this.
Amen.
There's so much going on.
Yeah.
So much, and it hurts, and it's all right to cry because God designed this, and you know, and we just cry, and then we just start praying.
Yeah, yeah.
Just start praying and allow the Spirit of God to flow. And as I shared with you last time about that quote from Winston Churchill, you know, while sometimes it feels like you're going through hell, well, keep going, we'll stay in it. Don't get comfortable.
Uh-huh.
Don't get comfortable in there, because then they'll say, okay, got you there, you're comfortable. So we're either reaching out for the beauty.
Yeah.
Estamos en dirección por el morso y la presencia de Dios, el poder de Dios. the beauty and getting rid of those ashes. Lord, wash away me impurity in my life, everything that is going on in our families, whatever is going on in situations all over this world. Mm-hmm. Lord, and bring forth the joy. And help me to put on that garment of praise, oh God. This week was like, oh my God, it was just like, and you know, I said, Lord, just wrap me in your arms. Teach me.
Yes.
I need more of your God. See, the moment we get so comfortable, we'll say, well, I guess this is it. It's like,
No, that's not it.
There's more to come. Right. Let me teach you. And it's all right. He grabs us by the ears and let me show you a few more things. And, you know, que Dios está manifestando y se sigue manifestando. And you know, when I had this message, I said, Lord, where are we going this week? Mm-hmm. You know, and where are we going today in this year? I said, as simple as that. Let me give you beauty for ashes.
Amen.
Let me give you the oil of joy for mourning for those areas that you struggle with, you know, whatever this world is going through, whether abuse, whether addiction, whether this, or that, or whatever it is, just depression, whatever. Let me just give you that oil of joy.
Amen. Praise God.
Let me give you that garment of praise. And you know, for those that want it, we have a world out there right now that has been seduced by opinion.
Yeah.
Seduced by so many isms. They've fallen into the snares of the enemy and they've accepted defeat. God doesn't want that.
No.
At all.
Right.
You know what I tell you? And today, just as a personal testimony, I was at a time frame in my life of just believing, stepping into Sunday church. Estaba en un momento de mi vida nomás creyendo y entrando a la iglesia. Y me dijo, mi Dios, necesitamos algo más. Necesitas algo más. La presencia del Espíritu Santo. La dirección en mí. I needed that presence of the Holy Spirit. I needed to submit in a spiritual way to be determined to believe and live for Him. In order for this to continue to flow in my life.
Yeah.
And see, many people out there don't know about this. Mm. A lot of times they just look at it as any other book.
Mm-hmm.
But there's so much power.
Yes.
When we submit to God.
That's right.
And in all this going on, I'll tell you one thing. I can share the areas of attacks of the enemy and everything else that was coming against me. But He's restoring.
Yes.
We got to declare and decree that this is a year of restoration.
Yes.
Es un año de restauración en nuestros familiares, un año de bendición, de hermosura, el aceite de gozo,
yes.
The oil of joy for mourning.
Yes.
You know, we just want to just come in agreement, in one accord, allow the Spirit of God to flow.
Amen.
And you know, whatever's going on out there, sometimes it's going to keep going and going. We just stay fully armored. Continue to pray. And believe for a demonstration of power.
Amen.
Una demostración de poder.
Yes.
Each and every one of you have a certain calling, certain gifting. They call forth anointing like fresh fire to reach out to those that are hurting.
Yes.
Whether the jail, highways and hedges, wherever it's set up.
Amen.
That they too will have this beauty for ashes.
Yes.
This oil of joy for mourning.
Yeah.
And the garment of praise. For the spirit of heaviness. I shared with the men at the jail, and we see a lot of premature death and a lot of cases that are, you know, areas of addiction or this or that's going on. I said, that shouldn't be the case.
That's right.
Nuestra juventud no se debía estar muriendo, falleciendo en la derrota del enemigo, en vicio o lo que sea. Hay que gozar de la vida, hay que aclamar la hermosura de Dios por medio de su salvación. As I shared with you last time about the prodigal son, and you know, he stayed out there doing everything he wanted to do.
Mm-hmm.
The father's here saying, come back. Let me bless you. El mensaje del hijo pródigo. Déjame bendecirte. Déjame librarte. Déjame restaurarte. Let me restore you.
Yeah.
In every way. And there's so much in this, so much of the beauty and the presence that I just don't want to cut him short, you know. He says, I've come that we might have life and heaven more abundantly. He venido para que tengas vida y la tengas en abundancia. Y les pido sus oraciones, porque estos días estuvo tremendo, pero gloria a Dios, quiere estar. I ask for your prayers for me. And continue on with the jail and every area that, you know, some in the train as a shared testimony in closing today. I was getting to Tucson and I heard this lady just run out of breath. And I was like, oh my God, what's going on back there? And we're just sitting by herself. This is Christmas Eve and probably on her way to see her parents or, excuse me, her family. And I look and nobody was getting up. And I said, what's going on back there? And I got up and I'm no doctor, you know, but we know whom we serve.
Yeah.
And I just went up to her seat. So just raise your hands up. He opens up the airwaves. Mm-hmm. And he gives glory to God. Mm-hmm. So raise up your hands. And you just raise them up. Come on, raise them up. Raise them up. And she was like, I was like, oh my God. And I just started to pray for her. Started to pray for her. I said, raise them up. Levanta tus brazos para arriba. Siga acabándose en el resuelo del tren. Iba mi suegro con a ver a su familia en Tucson. To see her family in Tucson. And I was like, oh my God. And God, nothing happened to her. I all of a sudden just started to breathe normal and feel better. Yeah. So I run down to the other cabin, the train, and get her a bottle of water. And I just give God the glory for all those moments that each and every one of you have.
Yeah.
And I want to say God bless you for the work that you continue to do in every way.
Amen.
And until there's more, let this be a year of restoration.
Amen.
I want to be restored in several areas. Cada uno de nosotros necesitamos ser restaurados. Financialmente, de salud, matrimonios, hogar, hijos. A lot of us want to be restored. Whether marriage, whether home, whether health, whether finances, whatever it is. Why not?
Yes.
Receive those blessings.
Amen.
And receive them today. And everything in the abundance. And I want to thank you once again for allowing me to be here today. You know, God is so awesome. You know, I'll tell you one thing. I mean, if I have to take this message to City Hall, so I want to take it to City Hall. It's all right to take the Word of God to the ivory towers of education, wherever it's at.
Amen.
Many have gotten so complacent.
Yeah.
Oh, no, what are they going to say, you know?
Uh-huh.
So right to declare and decree all over the nation and all nations.
Thank you, Lord.
We just want to praise Him because, especially now, they're trying to figure it out as how to, all these sociological problems and all these political problems, well, they're not going to figure it out until they get into the rules of the nation.
That's right. Amen.
Yes. And there's no genius around but the Father.
Yes.
He is the one.
Yes, He is.
Praise be to God. I want to thank you for your great opportunity to deliver the word as from your prayers, because see, there's more work to be out there.
Yes.
In Alpine, Marfine, all over the nation. And I want to thank my brother Rusty here and my Scott for bringing me, my Pastor Jose and Patricia for inviting me. I had a great time also with my brother Bernard here and his wife. And I'll tell you, all of you all are the beautiful people. And you know, the word says iron sharpens iron.
Yes.
Let's stay sharpened for such a time as this. Like, and you have to give me a spiritual punch. I like to use this. Give it to me.
Yeah.
I told a lady, I said, spiritual, don't close her face. I want to thank you. Yo creo que bendiga grandemente. Gracias por esta oportunidad de traer el mensaje. Y Dios siga bendiciendo grandemente. God richly bless you. And believe this is going to be a year of restoration in homes, in families, in our lives, and everything going on, because some of us here probably need a restoration. You don't have to say, well, I, you know, it's between you and God.
Yes.
Esa restauración. Es aceite de gozo.
Yes.
The oil of joy.
Yes.
The garment of praise. Get home, fire up the music. It doesn't even hear. Fire up the worship music in your vehicle, your prayers, your fasting, el ayuno, la oración.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes. Dios me lo bendiga grandemente. God bless you richly. And thank you for this opportunity to deliver the word. And we take on this year God's way with the rules of engagement.
Amen.
Thank you so much for everything. God bless you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Don't leave this.